Hello! This is Brother.
That didn't work, but progress.
Wait, it worked in the practice.
Speak right. Minutes, we need a bottle.
Hey, that went better. It's some grando.
How are we
doing? I'm wearing Woodford's t-shirt. Andrew's wearing his salt tear tubes. Promoting breweries and all that nonsense. This is the Walls County Town Brewery. And out at Northallerton, which I think is just a few train rides away. This is a Gundog Bitter. I can't remember where I picked this up. 4.1%.
I think you've got that one, I'm not sure.
Might be. Maybe from one of the trips I took with parents. And it's alive. It's a bottle condition beer. I think I may have picked this up in North Yorkshire. Went out with parents. Parents, because there's a bottle shop in. Where's Dad like to go? Skip to maybe. I think it's Tadcaster, maybe. No, I don't know. There's a bottle shop. There's a few bottle shops scattered around North Yorkshire.
What's that this?
Slab it tangerine, a little bit of orange. Yeasty.
Yeah. You definitely get that yeast in
the front. We've been having a lot of bottle condition beers today.
It kills you though.
But as you can see, we've poured it without sediment. There you go. That's poured it correctly. So we're going to try it without the sediment, and then we'll probably try it with the sediment.
Right. Before you drink it all.
Yeasty. Tangerine, touch of zesty orange.
It's quite fizzy on the tongue.
It's not as yeasty as the other beer we had. And that was very yeasty. That was from the Dunamassy Brewery.
Yeah. But
this is a lot more biscuit.
It's quite zingy on the tongue. Yeah.
You get that proper bottle conditioned beer.
You know what's the date on this one?
It's got plenty of date on it. It's expires February 2014. It's middle of October now, 2013.
I think maybe we would have been best trying it in March next year. Maybe it might have settled down.
After its date.
Yeah. It might have been. Because. What is it? 4.1%? I don't know. It's,
but,
to be honest.
We're going to see now.
Oh, it's flawed.
You see it? That's been shaken up.
Whoa.
It's almost like a chemistry experiment, isn't it?
Stuart dripping on my carpet again.
We need a bowl. You got a bowl?
It's stopped pouring now, I know.
You can see now the sediment in the thing. It's a little bit more cloudy. A little bit of tanned orange colour. It's a tanned head, would you say?
Well, you can't miss it anyway.
Yorkshire pour.
Manage it. Is it a fist? No,
yeah.
Well, on the head. Oh, let's pour it on this computer.
Me a poor man. Anyway, down that bit.
Poor man.
So we've tried it with the without the cinnamon.
That's quite smooth actually. We'll try it. I didn't sit down it.
No, I just get past the head. It's a little it's a little bit better with the cinnamon in it. You get a little bit more digestives, a little bit of malt biscuit. Definitely get more orangey tanginess. There's a slight bit of sweetness, almost like icing sugar. So I'll pour it carefully now. Because it's been shook up anyway, so.
I see what you mean by icing sugar, because that has a nice sort of like almost tastes like fondant.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, like the stuff to put on cakes or something. You know what I mean?
It's a little more funkiness to it now that it has been shaken up. Mm. It gives it a little more almost like an apricot mango presence.
Almost marzipan, or
yeah. But considering this is another bottle condition we're about tonight, it's not bad. We poured it without the cinnamon. Poured it with the cinnamon. Which is your favourite out of two?
I'd say I've got to go with cinnamon because, in a way, it's sort of counteract the yeast in it.
Yeah. Let's have a look, see what it says. Brewed from Perla, Cilia, and Cascade hops to give a rounded bitterness and a spicy citrus flavour. I suggest pouring a little bit carefully and then trying it with the cinnamon as well. Just for basically, so you can see
that we're done tonight. Yeah,
yeah. It's a perfect way of entrance into bottle condition beer.
Yeah.
This is a buy again. I would buy this again. Yeah, I mean,
If I had to buy this one, I'd probably leave it for about
until
6 months or something.
Leave it until February.
Anyway, I'd probably leave just a little bit past new just to push it a bit. Because in a way, when it's like that, I think maybe it needs maturing for like 6 months or something.
But I know a lot of people bottle conditioner beers to give that cask feel. You do get a cask feel once you pour the sediment in it, don't you?
Yeah. You got to pour the sediment in, though. That's the thing.
Just before, it would just...
Too yeasty. Yeah. You're getting a lot of biz in your tongue. You know what I mean? So you're almost sour beer, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But not sour beer. It's...
But otherwise, a nice beer, either way, but just a little bit better with sediment.
Yeah.
Yeah. You take care.
Bye.
Bye.